This video is an introduction to the software XFOIL, and we'll answer the question, what is XFOIL? This video, of course, is brought to you by The Science of Flight, a new brand here on YouTube dedicated to aerospace engineering, education, and software. Let's get to it. The question this video seeks to answer is, what is XFOIL? XFOIL is software that was developed for dealing with airfoils. A quick definition of airfoils is that an airfoil is nothing more than a two-dimensional shape of a cross-section of a wing. For instance, if you look at the image here on the right at that plane, you will see that on the left wing, there is shaded black. The shape that would be developed, or the shape that would be there if you sliced the wing at that location and looked at the cross section. So that black is just, that black area on the left wing is just the airfoil at that particular location. Obviously, this wing does not look to be uniform. So if I went to a different location on the wing and sliced it, looked at the cross section, the shape of the cross section, which would just be the airfoil, it'll be different. So this is part of the reason why it's so important to be able, as an aerospace engineer, be able to analyze airfoil shapes or design airfoil shapes, because you can take airfoils and assemble them together into a 3D shape. Or you can take a 3D shape, cut it up into 2D panels, 2D cross sections, and analyze the shape and determine how the air is going to flow around it. So that's kind of the idea behind an airfoil. It's a 3D representation of the cross section of a wing, or it could be a propeller blade or a turbine blade in an engine. So that's kind of what an airfoil is. So XFOIL is software that was developed for the aerodynamicist to be able to both design and analyze an airfoil. Now there's a little bit different meanings in those two words. Design kind of has the implication that you know your mission requirements, which would be, in this case, maybe you know the altitude you're gonna fly at, you know the velocity of the aircraft, what it's gonna fly at. So basically the flow that's gonna happen around the aircraft is known. And so you wanna design a shape of an airfoil to be able to produce the required lift in that particular mission. So that would be designing the airfoil, right? You don't have the shape yet. You're just trying to figure out what shape would work for your mission requirements. Now, analysis is different. Analysis is when you know the shape and you want to know, you know what the shape is, and you're trying to determine the performance of the airfoil. You know, so I took the slice of the wing right there on that right image, and I see that airfoil. I can put it in. I can figure out what the coefficient of lift is going to be, what the coefficient of drag is going to be, and so that's kind of the idea of analysis. Now, XFOIL is actually software that is designed to do both. It's designed to both design an airfoil and analyze an airfoil, and we'll talk a little bit about some of the functionality that it has for both of those methods on the slides that follow. Now, a quick note is that XFOIL is actually designed for subsonic airfoils. So make sure that you're staying within the realm make sure you're just staying subsonic so that the software is giving valid results. Now, XFOIL is actually based on the panel method that you learn from a theoretical aerodynamics course or from theoretical aerodynamics. And I'll go ahead on the end slide, go and throw a link to a theoretical aerodynamics series for you. So if you're wanting to read more about or learn more about panel methods, it will have some videos in it coming up shortly about the panel method for you. Now, XFOIL is actually, this software is actually a command prompt or command line style software. So it's not a GUI, there's not buttons, there's not menu, there's all the menus, all the commands are going to be entered on a command prompt. Now, some of these commands are hidden on different menus. There's the top level menu, obviously, and then there's other lower level menus. So depending on what you're trying to do, you might need to change what menu or what level you're on, then find your command, and then you'll be able to execute your command. But we'll talk about that in a following video. We'll kind of do a deep dive into that hierarchy, all of those commands, the different menus in this series. This series is kind of designed to take you from zero to being the subject matter expert for XFOIL. So stay tuned, there's lots of good content to follow with that. Alright, where was I? Alright, so XFOIL was actually created in 1986 by Mark Drella of MIT. Now, Harold Ljunggren, you'll hear his name quite a bit too. He assisted in future developments with Mark and definitely put in a lot of work on this software as well. So I just want to make sure that his name got in here. There is also others, you know, this is released under the general public license, so it's open source software. There's probably many other people who contributed pieces to develop the code to what it is today. We'll talk about that more too. And the actual code is, the source code for XFOIL is written in Fortran. And kind of the idea behind part of the series is to actually go into source code and learn how it accomplishes some of the stuff it does in its code. Obviously, we don't want to treat this software like a black box and not understand it. So we'll want to go in, we want to see the methods it's used, the algorithms, the equations, so we can understand how it works, maybe what built-in assumptions are there, so that we can make sure that we can trust our results, we know our results. And we'll be covering a lot of this in future videos, so stay tuned. In the last slide, we talked about the difference between designing and analyzing an airfoil. So I just wanted to go ahead and give a slide to talk about some of the capabilities of XFOIL for analyzing an airfoil. On the next slide, I'll talk about some of the capabilities of XFOIL for designing an airfoil. As an undergraduate aerodynamics student or an engineer in an Aero 101 course, you'll probably spend most of your time analyzing an airfoil. But this series will cover both analyzing an airfoil and designing an airfoil using the XFOIL tool. Now, some of the capabilities that XFOIL has to analyze an airfoil is that it is able to, using the panel method that we mentioned before, predict lift and drag just beyond the maximum coefficient of lift. So we should be able to not just get our typical behavior, but also to see the stall location, where it stalls, and what kind of a stall occurs from XFOIL. We're also able to do both a viscous and an inviscid analysis of an airfoil. Now, one of the really powerful capabilities of XFOIL is that you're able to take that airfoil and not just analyze it in one particular Reynolds number, one particular Mach number, one particular angle of attack, but you're actually able to sweep through Reynolds number, sweep through Mach number, sweep through angles of attack to analyze the airfoil in multiple orientations or flow situations. And so that kind of automates some of the analyzing tasks that you would have to do. So you don't have to run it for each individual one. You're able to go and sweep through it. And then, of course, some of the other capabilities is you're able to specify a forced location or let the location be free and determined by the software on the transition of the boundary layer from laminar to turbulent. You're also able to look at transitional separation bubbles, look at limited trailing edge separation, and do some compressibility corrections. So these are some of the analysis capabilities of XFOIL. And of course, since this is a series, there's going to be plenty of videos talking about each of these different capabilities, the commands you need to run them, what kind of results you get out of them, maybe any analysis or assumptions built into the analysis. So if there's something in particular you're wanting to see, maybe a specific tutorial, throw it in the comments below. I'm happy to add to the curriculum that is planned for this course. So go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know what kind of analysis you're wanting to do. The capabilities of XFOIL to design an airfoil usually falls into one of two categories. The first category is manipulating the geometry of a pre-existing airfoil to make it be the geometry of the airfoil you want. So for instance, you would change the maximum thickness or the location of the maximum thickness. There's various ways in the software, various commands or methods that you can use to alter the camber line for dealing with the radius of the leading edge, for changing the thickness of the trailing edge, for dealing with flaps or blending multiple airfoils together. So these all can kind of be grouped together into the category of taking an existing airfoil and changing its geometry to be something else, to be the airfoil you want. So that's kind of the first category of general design capabilities of XFOIL. The second category is this, you'll hear it's often called either the full inverse method or the mixed inverse method. They use different methods, of course, to go about designing an airfoil for a particular requirement. And these pretty much are designing the airfoil by changing the surface speed distribution. And we'll talk more about these in a future videos, but I just kind of wanted to throw out there and kind of give a brief introduction to some of the design capabilities of XFOIL. Now, if you're not familiar with some of the geometry of airfoils, or maybe some of the introductory aerodynamics topics, I'm going to, on the end card of this video, a link to another series I'm doing right now at the same time as this one about aerodynamics. So there'll be a video up on that one soon about the geometry of airfoils, the geometry of wings, and some of the values that we are looking for when we're designing or analyzing airfoils, like the coefficient of lift, coefficient of drag. So if you're wanting to kind of brush up on that or maybe learn more about that, go ahead and check out that other series and I'll be posting videos soon about these topics. And yeah, tell me what you think. That's the end of this first video of this new series on mastering XFOIL. The goal of this series is to bring you from absolute beginner to subject matter expert on this airfoil design software. So if you like what you saw and you want to see some more, then go and show your support for this channel by liking, commenting, and subscribing. In the comments below, go ahead and put what features you feel are missing from the current release of XFOIL. What features do you think will make it better, or what features do you think need to be improved upon or enhanced? So go ahead and throw that in the comments below. And in the next video, since XFOIL is based on panel methods, we're going to discuss panel methods and how that relates to XFOIL. So go ahead and click on that link and watch the video. We'll see you in the next video.